Welcome learner, Department of Collegiate and Technical Education has provided us online teaching and learning platform through LMS. Under this program, we take up the course PCB Design and Fabrication Lab. Subject code is 15EC56P for 5th semester diploma in ENC students. Under this unit 1, Transmission Lines and Crosstalk, session 11 now. Crosstalk, what is crosstalk in PCB? The term crosstalk explained differently in PCB. When two tracks travels for a long distance in a PCB, the inducing of the voltage to the nearby track is called crosstalk. The track which creates the crosstalk is called aggressor. The track which suffers from the crosstalk is called victim. Crosstalk control in PCB. Following steps should be followed to control the crosstalk in PCB. First one, design the PCB tracks as a transmission line. Should not route the tracks for a long distance in a PCB. That is considered parallel running of the track. Increase the spacing between the tracks. Even if you route the track for a long distance, but should not route those tracks for throughout the length of the track. Crosstalk control again. Vary the separation between the tracks is one of the important steps should follow the minimization of the crosstalk. While routing the sensitive tracks like analog signals, has to take special care. Maintain much separation from the digital noisy tracks. Planes in PCB. There are mainly two types of planes in PCB. First one ground plane, second one power plane. Planes in PCB, ground plane. Ground plane is a plane, a complete layer can be used for ground here, which is used for the ground. Either it may be a digital ground, DGND, or analog ground, AGND. The voltage at the ground should be 0 volt theoretically. Power plane. Power plane is a plane, a complete layer can be used for power here, which can be used for analog voltage or digital voltage. It is continuous conducting path assigned for particular voltage, either 5 volt or 3.5 volt. Or 12 volt. Planes in PCB, the ground plane and the power plane can be again classified as full plane, split plane, partial plane. Full plane, the diagram shown here is the full plane. Here it represents the full plane. This is connected plane. This plane is assigned to, particularly assigned to one voltage. Either it may be assigned to ground or it may be assigned to VCC. The entire layer can be used for either ground or power. This layer is mainly useful for designing transmission lines in the PCB. The track above the plane at outer layer is called microstrip. The tracks above this plane is called as microstrip. Split plane. This is a digital ground, this is the analog ground. This is a digital power, this is the analog power. Digital power and analog power should be connected somewhere. Digital ground and analog ground should be connected somewhere by using inductor. See here, this is one of the method. The inductor is connected between these two tracks, and the capacitor is connected somewhere here, C1. If the capacitor is connected between these two planes, is should be avoided. This is the right method of connecting the inductor between the two power planes, split plane. If the plane is split into two grounds, for digital ground and analog ground, then it is called a split plane. The plane can also be split into two power tracks present in the PCB, 5 volt and 12 volt are provided in same plane. Strip line and micro strip line impedance can be calculated with the reference to the plane. Partial plane. Partial plane is the plane. In this plane, the copper area is also can be used for routing the tracks. Here one copper area is assigned to AG and D. Here one copper area is assigned to digital ground. Apart from that, this and this point can be connected through the track or trays, but separation should be provided between this trays and the power plane. There connectors in PCB. There are different types of connectors available in the PCB: backplane connectors, battery connectors and holders, board to board connectors, cartridge connectors, memory card connectors, PCB connector accessories, PCB headers. Backplane connectors. What is the backplane connector? This type of connector is engineered to increase the data rates and decrease the signal rise, delivering a more reliable high-speed transmission with greater clarity. While designing such kind of connectors, the impedances of the connector pins are calculated and which should be matched to the track impedance of the PCB. Then the signal can be smoothly flows through the PCB and signal rise and bouncing should be reduced. Battery connectors and holders. Such kind of holders you might have been seen in your clocks, wall clocks. A battery holder is one or more compartments or chamber for holding a battery. Battery connectors and holders. For dry cells, the holder must also take electrical contact with the battery terminals. For wet cells, cables are often connected to the battery terminals. Wet cells you might have been seen in automobiles and emergency lighting equipments. Here, the cables are often used to connect the batteries. But for dry cells, are connected with holders. Board to board connectors. This is on PCB board. This is another PCB board. This PCB connected to this PCB by using such kind of connectors. Board to board connectors. This type of device is engineered to provide signal connections between two printed circuit boards. That is what I told. This is one PCB. This is another PCB. These two PCBs are joined together by using this connector. Card edge connectors. Card edge connectors are used to insert the SIM or used to insert the memory card. Such kind of connectors are used in the mobile phones. An edge connector is the portion of a printed circuit board consisting of traces leading to the edge of the board that are intended to plug into a matching socket. For this connector, a matching socket can be used. This kind of matching sockets. Or some connectors or some devices can be inserted here. That should have matched pins to these pins. Card edge connectors. The edge connector is a memory saving device because it only requires a single discrete female connector. The male connector is formed out of the edge of the PCB. And they also tend to be fairly robust and durable. They are commonly used in computers for expansion slots, for peripheral cards such as PCI, PCI Express, and AGP cards. Memory card connectors. So this is the memory card connector used in your mobile. These kinds of connectors mainly used in your mobile phones. These kind of connectors used for connecting your SIM. Termination techniques in PCB. Why termination required in PCB? What is a reflection? Reflection occurs when a signal travels down the length of a conductive medium and encounters an impedance mismatch. This can occur due to natural imperfections within a trace. Whenever a trace sees, there is a change in width of the track. Then there will be a reflection. Why the reflection takes place? When there is a change in width, impedance of the track will be varied. Therefore, the signal reflects back. The portion of the signal travels back to the source. This problem is called as reflection. In order to minimize the reflection, termination is required. Termination techniques in PCB. This is the driver pin. This is the receiver pin. This is the driver IC. This is the receiver IC. The signal traveled from driver pin to the receiver pin. There will be an impedance mismatch in the track. The signal traveled is appears as the receiver and looks like this. Therefore, we are inserting a resistor here. Once we insert the resistor here, the driver pin impedance will match to the track impedance. Therefore, the reflection is reduced. Therefore, the signal becomes smooth here. When there is a impedance mismatch, the signal will appear like this. It will goes up and there will be a reflection. There will be a ringing. Now ringing has been removed. The signal become proper now. Types of termination. One, series termination. Second, parallel termination. Third, Thevenin's termination. Fourth, AC termination. Series termination. This is the method how the series termination is provided. Always, series termination resistor is inserted at the driver end. not the receiver end. Now the impedance of this driver pin is 25 ohm. We are inserting a resistor of 25 ohm. Now total impedance of the driver pin is 50 ohms now. Transmission line is designed for 50 ohm. Therefore, transmission line impedance is matched to the driver pin impedance. Therefore, reflection is removed. Series termination. Series termination, you place the resistor near the driver to increase the impedance at the source and prevent reflections on the driver end of the trace. A resistor value is selected so that the combined sum of the termination resistor and the driver output are equal to the impedance of the trace. Second one, parallel termination. What is parallel termination? In parallel termination, the resistor is connected at the destination end and the resistor other end is connected to the ground or may be connected to the VCC. Here the transmission line impedance is 50 ohm. Parallel termination. Parallel termination is the simplest termination technique. A resistor R connects the load end of the transmission line to ground or VCC. This resistor can connect either to the ground or VCC. The value of R must match the characteristic impedance Z0 of the line to eliminate the reflection. The parallel termination consumes the greatest amount of power and is not recommended for low power applications. Thevenin's termination. Compared to the parallel termination, Thevenin termination pattern looks like this. Here two resistors are connected. If the ICs used here is the TTL and CMOS technology, then the Thevenin's termination provided is like this. This resistor connected to the VCC one end and R1 resistor other end connected to the ground. But in ECL technology, the logic 1 and logic 0 are VCC is the logic 1, VE is the logic 0. Therefore, pull-up resistor is connected to VCC, pull-down resistor is connected to the VEE. Therefore, the engineer has to refer the data sheet before providing the termination resistor. Thevenin's termination. The Thevenin termination, two resistors where the parallel resistance matches the impedance of the trace. While both the resistors could function as a pull-up or pull-down for the signal, the Thevenin termination result in constant draining of the current or regardless of the state of the driver. AC termination. This is the AC termination method. AC termination is also called as RC termination, resistor capacitor termination. Instead of simple R, a capacitor is also used here. That is the main difference between Thevenin's termination and AC termination. Other than that, everything is correct. If it is TTL or CMOS technology, the resistor can be put like this and the capacitor can be replaced like this. This is also proper method of providing the AC termination. This is also good AC termination. The addition of the capacitor mitigates the power dissipation problems of the other parallel termination schemes, blocks low frequency noise and minimize overshoot and undershoot. These are all the references I have taken from the papers. Thank you for watching.